Hello and welcome to another aircraft tutorial in MSFS. This right here is the Douglas DC-3 that also has recently been added to the sim via the 40th anniversary edition. And it's quite a beautiful bird, as you can see. We are going to do a little tutorial flight today. I'm going to show you how to properly start the engines, because nobody seems to do it right on YouTube. And I'm also going to explain to you the Sperry Gyropilot, so this very ancient autopilot that is included in this aircraft in the classic version. And we are going to do a little tutorial hop from Sedona Airport in the USA, Kilo Sierra Echo Zulu, to Grand Canyon Airport, which is Kilo Golf Charlie November. We are going to do some VOR flying, so I hope you will enjoy the trip. And now let's get into the aircraft, and I'm going to show you how to operate this bird, this very classic one right here. So here we are. As you can see, it's a very, once again, a very classic aircraft. Many of these big handles, hydraulic levers and analog gauges all over the place, so there's nothing modern in here. All right, let's start at this overhead panel. As you can see, these two switches at the left hand side, this is the quick start switch and also a cold and dark switch. So we are going to flick on the cold and dark switch, and this will set some more things to a realistic cold and dark state, but not all of them. So let's go down here. We are going to ensure that the parking brake is set. These switches are off, the trims are neutral. This is the tail wheel lock, so we are going to make sure it's in the aft position. Or forward, yes, forward position. So it's locked. The trim is neutral, and here the pedestal we are going to take care of a bit later. These are the carb heat switches, and we are making sure they are locked in the cold position. So forward is cold and aft is hot. These are the turbo blower switches or handles. They are in the aft position, which is correct. Fuel tanks are off for now. And what else? We can make sure that we have enough hydraulic fluid. This ball right there. That's awesome. This handle is in the aft position. The yellow one is the flaps handle. And below the pilot seat, we have the gear handle, which is down and locked via this thingy right there. That's correct. This is the hydraulic pump, the manual hydraulic pump. And the cowl flap switches are closed and off right now. And I think that's pretty much it for the initial cold and dark status. So let us begin to power this bird up. Okay, let's begin by turning on the ground power. And this will also place this ancient red GPU card on the outside. And I think in there are the batteries of the aircraft. Okay. Ground power is established. We are going to check the fuel gauges. So down here you have the fuel indicator. And we are going to cycle through all the tanks that we have. Okay, so the aux tanks are not as full as the main tanks, as you can see. Alrighty, next we are going to... Yeah, the cowl flaps are already opened and off. They are closed, yeah. We are going to open the cowl flaps. Switching them to open. By the way, before we do that... They won't open because we don't have any hydraulic pressure at the moment. Down here you can see the hydraulic pressure gauge, and it's zero. In case you need hydraulic pressure to open the cowl flaps or operate the flaps or gear or anything that is hydraulically operated in this aircraft, which is a lot, we need to build up some pressure manually. So we are going to open this red valve right here. And then we can pump the hydraulic pump six times. 3, 4, 5, and 6. And close the valve again. Now you can see we have some hydraulic pressure. And it's still rising because of the pumping. So when we now open the cowl flaps, you can see that they are actually opening because we have hydraulic pressure now. And that's very useful when we are... And that's very useful when you are in a very hot spot, for example on a hot day, and you need the cowl flaps immediately so the engines won't blow up after engine start or catch fire. That is quite nice to have. Alright, that was pro tip number one. Now let's begin with the engine startup right here. Startup. Propeller levers forward. And mixture levers also forward. We make sure that everything else is in the off position. Off, 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 everything off right here as well. Except the ground power, and we are going to switch on the position lights as well. We are going to make sure that the flight controls are free and correct. So left and right aileron, forward and aft, and rudder. Everything is working. Alright, next up. Once again, we make sure the parking brake is set, the tailwheel is locked. Carb heat is cold, which it is. Forward position is cold, and it's locked. Now also we are going to select the main tanks for the fuel, so left main tank right here, right main tank on the other side, and the rest is fine. Now we are going to switch on, or we are going to crack the throttles first, so range is free and correct, and now they are cracked. Also this green light at the side, that means the gear is down and locked. Okay. Now let's start the booster pumps. This is optional. You can also start the engines without them, but as we're at a very high elevation airport, let's turn on the booster pumps. And we are going to open the right window to hear things from the right engine that we are going to start first. Okay, next. We are going to prime the engine. For 5 seconds. So right engine primer. And that should be sufficient. Now the master ignition gets enabled. This is the pull or this push button at the magnetos panel right here. So this has to be in. Now right engine to both magnetos. And we are going to energize the right engine. Now some electrical whining sound should appear, but that's only working for the left engine when the battery is on. Now the mesh switch, and after turning on the mesh switch, we are going to wait for 16 blades approximately, or 15. So the engine will rotate the blades. And at around 10 to 15 blades, we are going to turn on the right primer once again. So let's do it. Mesh. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and now, right primer. And the engine came to life. And now we are aiming at an idle RPM of around 800. So there's 800. As you can see, that is not sufficient to build up enough oil pressure yet. So let's maybe idle at around 10, so around 1000 RPM. And there you can see the right engine is creeping over the red line, and now the light should extinguish as well at some point. I think it will extinguish when it's in the green band, but at least we're above a red line now for oil pressure. Fuel pressure is looking more than good, it's nearly too much. Alright, after the right engine has successfully started, we are going to enable the battery and turn off the ground power. We can also enable some cockpit lighting now. But that's hardly visible right now at bright daytime in Sedona. But here you can see it's a bit red glowing. Alright, now for the left engine start, we are going to prime it once again. For around 5 seconds. And that should be sufficient. Let's also open the left window to hear things. Now, magnetos to both. And we are energizing the left engine now. And now we can also hear this whining sound that should appear. Alright, now mesh. And we are again waiting for 15 blades to pass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Left engine primer. And both engines are running. So let's close the window because it's quite cold outside. That's also why we wouldn't necessarily need to open the cowl flaps. When it's very cold, you can also leave them closed. Alright, energized switch back to the off position. Yep, that's fine. Booster pumps off and inverter on. So, ground power is off, battery is on, lights are set so far. All is fine. Now let's take care of the instrumentation, so the radios and stuff. Right here you can set your squawk, and it's already set to VFR flight. And we are going to turn it to the standby on position, even though this switch is very strange. It has large steps, and they don't really fit for the writings right there. So whatever. Now let's tune in the first VOR that we need. And it will be Flagstaff VOR 113.85. And we make it active via this button. Up here we have comm radios, but we are not needing those for an ATC-less flight once again. And right here we have the ADF, the NDB radio, so to speak. And the second VOR that we are going to need for our arrival is Grand Canyon, which is 111.65. 111.65. We are going to prepare that. So we are only using NEV Radio 1 today for the flight, not NEV Radio 2. Okay, now the after engine start flows. We are making sure that the hydraulic pressure is fine and the temperatures. So now also the oil pressure warning lights have extinguished, 1000 RPM right here for the engines. Temperatures are in the green nearly and above red line right here as well for the cylinder. Carb air is quite cold. We can also, yeah, we are going to do that or whatever. Unlock, hot position and lock again. Set, and that should also rise the carb heat temperature. Hydraulic pressure is fine. Cowl flaps open. Yeah, all good. This right here, the yellow handle, is for the flaps, as I told you before. And to operate them, you must first enable the handle, so to speak, by pulling that out. And then you can lower them. And here we have the flap dial, or the indication for the flaps. And then we can stop the movement. Now they are set to 3/4. But for this runway, I think, yeah, we are going to do a quarter flap departure. So let's raise them again for a quarter. And that didn't really work. Now they're up. So down, and yeah, that's sufficient. And we are going to disable the flap selector. Okay, let's uncage the instruments. Uncage here, uncage there, and this as well, this very gyro pilot. And via this rotary, we are going to bring up this wings thingy. So, hydraulics are fine, radios are tuned, altimeters, yeah indeed, we need the altimeters as well. So it should be 3022 at the moment. Airport elevation is 4800 feet, so that's fitting. And on the co-pilot side as well. So, by the way, we have a temperature of 6 degrees. There's also a temperature indicator somewhere. Yes. Behind there. Okay, now we are going to make sure that our gyro is correctly set to the magnetic compass. So right here we have the magnetic one. It's at 210 degrees. And now we are double checking that also our primary gyro right here is correctly set. And that's also bound to the perigyro pilot. Compass right there, that's linked. Okay. Everything is set so far. Now for taxiing, let's pull out the tailwheel lock so it's unlocked and it can caster during taxiing. So for taxiing, I can recommend to open a window once again. I have a view set up for this window right here. So we can stick our head outside and we see more of the taxiways. And remember, this is a tail dragger, so you have to treat it like one. Can be a bit tricky to taxi. And also because of the reduced visibility to the front, it's quite an adventure. And also when braking, you have to make sure that the tail doesn't come up. And maybe the plane even starts flipping over. For me it's quite difficult to accomplish because I only have a trigger on the joystick to brake, so when coming to a standstill, then it might be that the tail rises a little bit. I'm sorry for that. I cannot brake more precisely. So here we have the whole short point. And now I'm sure the tail will come up. Ah, it even worked without it. Awesome. The tail stayed down. And here we are holding short. Runway 21, I think it is. I'm going to double check on the chart. Now we are holding short runway 3. And we are doing a little engine run-up. So at 1500 RPM. So that's 1500. Now let's do a quick feather test. So full range right here, you can see the RPM dropping, and the other side as well. And now a quick magneto test as well, as we are at it. So the RPM of the left engine are dropping around 100 RPM. That's fine. Left one is no different. So the left magneto. Right side. For the right side, engine 2 is the same, 100 RPM. Okay. Alright, now let's also set up runway heading for our autopilot. So as I said, this compass portion is linked to the real compass, so our real gyro. And the upper portion can be manipulated. So the aircraft can follow that heading then that has been set up right there in the upper portion. I'm going to set up 33 degrees, which is runway heading initially. And that's pretty much set now. This is 4, 5 and 6. So yeah, should be approximately right there. For the pitch portion of this gyro pilot, I'm not going to set up anything now further. Okay, now the before takeoff flows for now. Tailwheel is still unlocked. Mixtures are auto-rich. Propellers forward. Now let's again go into cold carb heaters. So unlock, cold and lock. Cowl flaps are in the open position, that is fine. Now let's turn on the landing lights. And the pitot heats, There's no need for any further anti-icing, so here's windshield anti-ice, prop anti-ice, and some more heaters. We are going to turn on the booster pumps. Carb heater auto de-icer, I think that can be enabled. Yeah, right, for takeoff we are going to switch the cowl flaps to the trail position. So that's also set now. In this position they open and close influenced by the wind, so by the pressure pretty much. So that's the setting for takeoff. Okay, let's line up with the runway. Alright, as you can see we are nicely aligned. Right here when all these numbers are on top of each other, then you are perfectly aligned. Should be the case. Now we are going to lock the tail wheel and we are going to trim up a little bit. Not too much, just a little. Flaps are set at 1/4 approximately. And I think we are good for takeoff. So we're going to spool up the engines, but not above red line right here. For the manifold pressure we have to stay below red line, so I think it's 48 inches. And we're doing it very gently and slowly. So right there approximately. Actually at this altitude it's full power. And now the tail is coming up already. And we are trying to stay on center line here. And now we are off the ground already. So climb speed shouldn't be below 80 knots, that's for sure. But the aircraft just wants to climb. So gear up. And we have to make sure not to stall right here. Now flaps up as well. And they are up. And now by rotating the VOR thingy, we can make sure to fly towards it. Okay, booster pumps off, landing lights off, and it can be quite tricky to fly this aircraft, especially when drunk, so excuse me for that. Let's bring back the prop levers, so they are below red line at least. And now we are trying to fly towards Flagstaff VOR. So right here you have the VOR needle and right here you have the dial. So when you change the heading right here, then also the needle will change. And when the needle is centered, then this dial is correctly set and you can read the heading, so north. Direct straight to north, that's how we have to fly. So, how do the temperatures look? We are quite hot. So let's open them, maybe. Carb heaters are cold, okay. So this plane is definitely no rocket. It's not very powerful. Climb speed around 120 knots is fine. And as you can see, we maybe have a climb rate of 1000 feet. So not much going on here. But we have to make sure not to fly into mountains. And we have to adjust our UR radio right there. So the needle is pointing to the right, as you can see, the white one. And that means, indeed, north is to the right. And that is correct. Shortly we are going to fly straight towards it. So current heading is 30. That's also the case for our primary gyro. So let's sync the heading. And we can nearly enable our Jerry Spyro pilot right there. Jerry Spyro, Sperry Gyro. However it's called. Okay. We are still going full thrust. And we are in the green. That wouldn't be possible when at lower altitudes, then we would be above red line already. Okay. So now it should be approximately 2 degrees or so, so 20 degrees. So let's turn to this heading. Temps are looking fine. This red light means that our gear is up. That's all right. And let's cruise at 10,000 feet, maybe. That's fine. So there we have the heading, approximately, that we need. There we have 10,000 feet as well, so let's level off. Yeah, it's pointing a bit to the left now. This green needle is for VOR2, we don't need that right now. We're still climbing, that's not good. Let's bring back the throttles a little bit at least. Now we are trimming out to stay level at 10,000 feet. At least try to. And again, we have to sync the heading on our autopilot right there. Okay, it doesn't even look that bad. We are pointing straight towards the VOR now. At around here, 10,000 feet. The heading is synced. The plane is not yet fully trimmed out, so we have to do that before engaging the autopilot. Would be optimal if that's the case. Okay, now let's engage the autopilot, because it's also quite bumpy in the air right here. Alright, down here, autopilot on, heading mode select. And it would be nice if the aircraft is climbing, so we are dialing up this Echo Lima Echo, this elevation dial right here. So if you are pulling or if you are turning this to the left, then the aircraft will climb, and if you are turning it to the right, the aircraft will descend, as you can see. Let's try to stay around this altitude right here. Okay, temperatures are looking fine. Still quite hot. So I'm going to leave the cowl flaps open. Let's engage some carb heaters to the hot position. And let's also switch our tanks to the aux tanks for cruise for now. As you can see, aux tanks also have sufficient fuel. And we are going to auto-lean the mixtures. So right here, this should be approximately auto-lean. We can even go full throttles. Yeah, approximately. Still in the green band. And let's pull back the propellers a little bit. So I guess that's quite a nice setting for cruise. And right here we have Flagstaff Airport. That is Flagstaff. Now we have to tune over to the other VOR. So by pushing this button, it should be to our left. So let's go this direction right here. Yep, and now we can see this needle is centered. We have to go heading 32 approximately. So let's disable heading hold. Let's dial in 32 degrees somehow. This direction. Yeah. And let's hit heading hold again. Also, we are climbing a bit. And now the aircraft should turn towards the next VOR, which is Grand Canyon, where we are heading to. Isn't she a beauty? I like this aircraft a lot. Even though it's very hands-on to fly. Okay, we have to turn further. Maybe I didn't even fully understand the nav radios yet, or this, yeah, the very classic nav radios. So this is centered, this is pointing towards 30, so let's turn towards 30 degrees and see what happens. Then it should be correct. Well, now it's to the right. It's a mystery right here. But we also have to make sure not to fly into mountains, so it's also not too bad to not go in a straight line towards the VOR. Alright, other than that, there's not too much to do. We don't have any icing, so we don't need anti-ice controls for now. Now for some reason we have a lot more manifold pressure, so let's dial them back a little bit. We are not even going 200 miles per hour, so we are quite slow. But that's how things were back in the day. Okay, the cruise checklist. Cowl flaps are as required. Yeah, temps are fine. I think I'm going to leave it like this. In the open position. And mixtures auto-lean, cruise tanks are selected, power adjustments, autopilot, all fine. Now we are at 10,500 feet. So let's maybe aim for that altitude, as we are a VFR flight as well. VFR flights often cruise at the 500s. So not the full altitudes, but you know what I mean, maybe. So once again, via the Jerry Sperry gyropilot, it will try to stay within this white box. And the white box is the thing that you move via the elevation wheel right here. So when the white box is above, then the aircraft will descend. Because the artificial horizon has to come up, and that's when the aircraft descends. And when the white box is below right here, then the aircraft will climb. I think. Maybe it's the other way around, who cares? Somehow it's working. Current heading is 30. Yeah, we have to adjust it a little bit. Gyro drift is enabled for the assistance options. So this can alter along the flight, and we have to make sure that it's always correctly set. Alright, also the VOR is pointing to the right, so we should also turn right maybe at some point. Let's disengage heading mode, climb a little bit, and go to, I don't know, 320. Okay, that's actually looking quite nice. Maybe it's also because of the crosswinds that we are not flying straight towards the VOR. Because right here it's now showing 33, we are at 32. That might be because of crosswinds. Who knows? Okay, fuel quantities are looking fine, temperatures are looking fine. Also our pressure and RPM gauges, everything is awesome. So I'm going to catch you back when we are nearly at our destination airport. There you can also see when setting the cowl flaps to trail how the wind blowing from the front is going to nearly close them completely. So this position is also only quite useful for taking off. Let's close them for now and see what happens. So close and then off, so there's no more hydraulic pressure on the cowl flaps. Alright, it might actually be that this right there is our destination airport, so let's descend right now. Let's dial down the autopilot to descend. Throttles back a little bit. Standing at maybe 1,000 feet per minute. And let's also turn a little bit more to the left. So the airport is to the right of us and we can land runway, what is it? Runway 3 once again. Runway 3 at Grand Canyon Airport. Okay, descending with 180 miles per hour, 1000 feet per minute. What does our gyro say? Around 335 degrees. Yep, that's fine. So the airport elevation is, I think, 6600 something. Yeah, around 6600 feet. So maybe 1,000 feet above airport elevation for starters. We are now at 9,000. Local pressure is 3025, so also right there is there's no big difference. That's now set. Let's turn on the landing lights. Maybe a bit early, but whatever. Okay, airport, where are you? There's also no DME in this aircraft type, no distance measurement equipment, so it's quite hard to tell. I think this right there is our airport. Looks like it. So maybe we should lose speed. Drops forward. Not too much. Maybe red band is a bit too much. Okay. Let's go back to main tanks. Left and right. Carb heater's cold. And let's also open our cowl flaps. 8000 feet now. Where's the airport? I think here, yeah, right there. Let's take over. Manual control. Autopilot off. This handle right here comes back to the aft position somehow, if it's working. Okay. 7000 feet now. 1000 feet about airport, or above airport elevation. Let's turn towards it. So before landing, we have autopilot off, altimeters are set, fuel selectors are on the main tanks. Not getting too slow. Mixtures are auto-rich. Not yet, but now they are. Suck. Suck. And there we have the airport inside. Awesome. It has worked, the classic VOR navigation. Now let's extend a little bit of flaps. Not too much. One quarter now. And we are landing with half flaps, I would say. So somehow, yeah. So the runway is the left one, the right one is the taxiway. Okay. I hope we have some peppy lights at least. And of course, you can also use the normal flaps down and up commands on the joystick. Fuel booster pumps on, and I think we are ready for landing. Gear is down now. Yes, green light. And I think we don't have any peppy lights. That's not so great. This is an add-on airport, a freeware add-on airport, and it doesn't feature peppy lights. Awesome. We can also sync the heading of our gyro pilot if we like to, approximately at least. Okay, 100 miles per hour is looking good. For landing, maybe 90. Flaps are set to 3/4. And with these classic aircraft, it's better to be high on the altitude than too low. Full props. And I'm no expert with these classic aircraft, I must say. But still, let's hope for the best. Okay, there we have some touchdown. Throttle's idle. And pulling back on the yoke a little bit to bring the tail down. There it is down. But still we are bouncing around the runway. Now braking. Pulling full back on the yoke, so the tail doesn't come up again when braking. Awesome. We made it. We landed. Tail wheel on. So tail wheel engaged. Let's try to find a taxiway. Let's raise the flaps. And there we have an exit. Awesome, welcome to Grand Canyon. That was interesting, that was an adventure. For a change. Flaps are raised. Lever off. There we are. Welcome to Grand Canyon Airport. I'm quite happy with the flight. The approach was adventurous once again, but the landing was quite smooth. And there the tail came up a bit when braking. That might happen. Okay, after landing flows, what do we have to do? We can... yeah, the cowl flaps are opened. Let's turn off the booster pumps and pitot heaters off, landing lights off. And what else did I forget after landing? Flaps, are the flaps up? Yes, they are up. Gear is down and green once again. Cowl flaps are open, boost pumps off. Trim, yeah, we can set the trim to neutral. Props are high RPM, tailwheel is unlocked. Awesome. Now we can look for a spot to park. And actually there are many free spots right here, so we have full choice where to park. Let's take this one straight ahead. Why not? And I'm also going to turn the aircraft around so it's not facing towards the fence. Let's do it! I love this tail dragger whipping around. This is awesome. Parking brake. And there we are. Is whipping around a real word in English? I don't know. So actually for parking there's not much to do. We can lock the tailwheel once again. And yeah, mixture's cut off. Left and right. And the engines are off. Okay, position lights off. And transponder to the off position. Inverter off. And magnetos off. And master ignition off as well. Lights off. And battery. Close the window. And we can switch these cowl flap switches to off, to the off position as well. I think that's it, actually. We can cage some instruments. So caging this one and pulling down this aircraft wing symbol thingy. And this one gets caged and this one as well. Even though I'm not entirely sure. It's a bit strange, a bit bugged maybe. But pulling this out should cage the instrument. Carb heaters are locked in the cold position. And we can also shut off the fuel tanks. Oops, that was the blower. Off here, off there. Awesome. Parking brake is set. And we are good to leave the aircraft, I would say. So this was quite an interesting flight with this classic retro prop aircraft right here. I hope you enjoyed it. It was fun. Especially when not entirely sober. So, I will see you next time for the next tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If not, then it's fine. Whatever, I will see you next time. Goodbye.